one hard guy is better than five soft guys. I think any woman would realize that. And when you listen to Zappa's solos, such as Friendly Little Finger on the Zoot Allures album, you'll see that here's a man who, using an arch Victorian sensibility, was able to materially melt down all punk rock aesthetics into one blazing, sizzling guitar chorus that evokes all the Sex Pistols' great hits, such as God Save the Queen and Anarchy in the UK. He sort of evokes them both during the guitar bridge of that song. Sex Pistols, huh? Never heard of them. Yes, Sex Pistols, sir. My son was drunk. He was a drunkard. And I think as a drunkard, he succeeded admirably in getting across a certain vomitous, bad blues posturing. I think ripping off black people is all very well and good. My son did it very well, emulating Big Mama Thornton, and I mean big, and emulating other blues R&B artists. I think you should give him some credit for this. No, I think clearly he needs to be discredited. I think a person should sing in their own voice. Getting back to Friendly Little Finger on Zoot Allures, you'll notice that Zappa, at the end, using Hendrix's rebuilt, charred Fender Stratocaster from Miami Pop Festival, is able at the end of that piece to presage Greg Ginn's guitar on the very first Black Flag single, Damaged. Zappa was a prophetic sensibility constantly at work, debunking, pushing the aesthetic envelope, and trying to deliver some kind of real news and hope for most Americans who think. As he himself said, my music is for those who have outgrown the ordinary. Whereas the Grateful Dead are just a traveling sha-na-na type roadshow, doing soulless retreads of Beatles songs, Dylan songs, you know, the usual Robert Johnson blues things. I think the fact they do the same thing over and over is consistent. It's good. Yes, well, you might think that way, but did it not claim your son's life and other druggies' lives in the process? Let's talk about the Altamont concert where a black man was stabbed to death. Jerry's comment was merely, oh wow. And then they wrote a song about it saying, in the heat of the day, a man died of cold. Clearly he did not die of cold, he died of stab wounds and being stomped by Jerry Garcia's friends, the Hells Angels. What do you think about that? Did I mention I have money? And I can possibly sue you for defamation of character. Character is something you do not possess, nor do you know the dimensions of. The contour of your dilemma is quite clear. You are both mystified by the egregious trappings of hippiedom, using it as a force, a shill, a three-card Monty game, for your own personal gain and that of your family. Yes, your coffers are full, but unfortunately, your philosophical approach is quite porous. It is poor indeed. It is lacking in any kind of stretch, dimension, or imagination. I think Zappa's aesthetic clearly embraces the very best of highbrow culture and lowbrow culture. Plus, if you look at the band members down through the years, he was actually able to jam with great musicians. Not five guys getting together over and over in some kind of bogus garage band retread. Well, did I mention that my son, Pigpen, was able to drink and sing at the same time? Sometimes singing and drinking at the same time. Besides, he had an association with Janis Joplin, another drinker and singer, and I think they were able to help foster the pop mythology that keeps kids drinking, singing, doing drugs to this day. It's been a grand American tradition and one that's made money for Mr. Weir here. Did I mention I'm from Atherton, California? My son started in bluegrass music and met Jerry Garcia. I think they've been able to make lots of cash off the kids. And I sell tie-dyes on the side myself. I pull my 59 Impala into the parking lot sometimes, and I'm actually able to sell these really bad silk screens of dancing bears that me and my wife do in our spare time when we're not attending luncheons with the John Birch Society. Incidentally, the John Birch Society, I'm afraid we have to cut you off, Mr. Weir. Well, that concludes yet another very interesting segment of Zappa versus the Dead. We thank Bob Weir's dad, Pigpen's dad, and of course, Marshall McLuhan, providing insightful commentary into myth, pop culture, and the deconstruction of thought. Listen up, everyone. We're a bunch of silly hippies, and we're doing what we want. We're really, really free. We're growing our hair. Hair means we're free. Very free. We're very free people. We're free, 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 free. We're hippies. We're very, very free. Oh, we're very free. But then later we'll grow up and each have four kids and have Beamers and Lexuses of our own. And we'll be able to watch Donahue all day long and eat Pop-Tarts because we're free. We're free. Mommy and Daddy are allowing us to go to college and do lots of drugs.
And now,
Deadheads, jaw down. The man on the street, deadhead. The Joe next door, deadhead. Here for your delectation. I remember a show I saw with the boys, I think it was Ontario. One thing I like about the dead, they don't allow many niggers at the shows. When I was in the Klan, one of the songs the boys and I liked was that Casey Jones song. Sometimes during a lynching, I just found myself whistling it. Maybe a little off-key, but I don't think the boys would mind. Jerry and the boys should sell shoes. The way they sell that for cock, the stuff they do. Well, I used to work at the post office. I used to work at the post office with that drummer, there's Bill. I remember Bill was always hitting on, you know, drumming on everything, counters. Jerry and the boys are the voice of America. When I was in the mouth of Russia and there was a repression, I would hear the happy tones of freedom ringing.
I used to be a deadhead, but I done give up on them. You see, I saw Bessie Smith live in 1929, and I don't feel the boys. One thing I really like about the boys is, well, they have lots of money. And money is the greatest psychedelic of all. And sometimes when I do a dose, you know, some window pane, and I start seeing gold cards and Visa cards dancing with the little bears.
Jerry, good boy. I know Jerry from Fish Market in San Francisco, and he plays steel guitar.
I remember when Charles Manson, my dear boyfriend, first got out of Terminal Island. And we went on down to the Avalon Ballroom, and the boys were doing Dark Star, and Jerry was peeking, and the acid was peeking. Chuck just rolled himself up into a little fetal ball in front of the stage, and it was like he was reborn or something. And ever since then, everywhere I go, I pray for the boys, and I believe that Jesus sent them here to rescue mankind from its limitations, and make them whole, and make them realize the power of why we're here.
Yes, I come from India. Many years ago, I follow the Grateful Dead then. I enjoyed very much as exchange student listening to their tunes in Rangoon. Their music seemed to evoke the sitar. But then later, I got into a very good album by PIL, Public Image Limited, with Ryuichi Sakamoto, and yes, Steve Vai, and yes, Johnny Lydon, formerly the boy called Johnny Rotten. And I realized just how paltry and small the Grateful Dead music is in comparison to the overarching, massive sound that Johnny could evoke with this great band. Did I mention they had Ginger Baker on drums also? So now, I give up on the Grateful Dead. I realize they rip off Indian tradition. They talk of mantra, but they know nothing.
Jerry came down here one time, they did a dance, and what I remember most is they played a lot of them songs about drugs.
Mar and I, when we get out on the road again, out of the White House, and we start touring with the boys, when I can get shed of this Brooks Brother monkey suit that I have on, put on some of my Dancing Bear tie-dyes again, I think I'll be like Thoreau. And like this man, the guy that scalped me tickets for their show at RFK Stadium.
Well, they were good seats, George. What can I say? How about that tab I gave you backstage? Jerry, I'm trying to cut off my middle finger, you notice? Just like Jerry did, so I can see my middle finger? I'm trying to cut it off.
There is a tribute indeed. Former president cutting off middle finger just to emulate guitar here. I think that's something all of you should do. Bodily mutilation, pretty good. I do lots of bodily mutilation for the CIA. Oh, that tab's kicking in right now, Bar. Bar, I feel like I'm back in Vermont. Sucking sap from a tree again. Oh, all you people are just molecules now to me. That tab's hitting pretty good right about now. Bar, Mama, mommy, 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 mommy. I feel my Texas roots. I feel the Alamo drifting through my skull with Davy Crockett following green swordfish up a Nile. That's better. As I was saying, a great example by a great American. Following the dead is that LSD 25, we perfected at the CIA, is coming back in now. I'd like to read a few words that Barr and I wrote in tribute to the band. If I can, yeah, I feel better. This is for Jerry. Jerry, you are a cult of mystery. You are a man of mystery. Barr, I feel like I'm picking ticks off my dog's belly. Barr, whatever you do, don't sell that cow, Barr. Bow your heads in prayer and listen to the words of Dark Star by Jerry and the Boys. Or he's gone. That's my recommendation to all Americans. Drugs are good. Drugs are good. Drugs is faith. Faith is drugs. God is drugs. God is the mystery and molecular structure that drifts through all of us, bringing us peace and tranquility. I feel that the Bay of Pigs and the Avalon Ballroom are one and the same at times. You see, we're all just molecules and motes drifting through the universe, interacting electrically, little electric grids there. I'd like to gather my notes and tell you Americans, oh, that was some good cocaine one of the boys gave me. I just had the sniffles. But as I conclude this speech here, I feel the patriotism the dead evoke through good American values. Making lots of cash and keeping it is something we all could learn from. Money, 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 CIA, money, LSD, CIA, money, LSD, CIA, money, LSD, CIA, money, LSD. That's my mantra. Jerry and the boys believe in it. They said it at Candlestick Park when they were singing the national anthem subliminally. They got that message across. Warping all of you in the process, getting you to fall in line, getting ready for the new world order. Orders from above, orders from underneath, orders from inside me. You see, the boys stand for American fascism at its best. They are able to do bad versions of every form of music that ever existed, making it mediocre, ignorant, and American, all in one fell swoop. And that's what we stand for, is ignorance, mediocrity, reducing things to our level. Beer-guzzling truck drivers, that's what we want to be. Kmart, Pick and Save, The Grateful Dead, the three cornerstones of American life.